Hello everyone, my name is Bethany and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing my March wrap-up as indicated in this title. So, March has been kind of a rough month for me. I've posted on Twitter and Instagram Insta stories. At the very beginning of the month, I lost my grandfather, so this month kind of hit me really hard and it's been tough. So I didn't really do a lot of reading this month, and obviously it impacted my reading, and I had a set TBR and I was trying to like read within my TBR, but there was a couple mood reads that I threw in. Yeah, it was kind of a rough month reading wise, especially compared to January and February when I did like 21 and 18. I didn't do that many. I didn't do that as high numbers this time. I'm so sorry. This month so far, I have 9. I will probably be able to finish the 2 that I'm in the middle of right at the end of the month that I'll be able to wrap up. Probably at the very end. I'm just going to be talking about what I've read so far this month and wrap it up at the end with probably the last 2 things that I finished that I can talk about. So I might also talk about my April plans. I don't know. I'm winging it. I haven't really decided. It's been weird because I haven't filmed in like 2 weeks. So getting back in the swing of filming again. All right. So to start off with, the first thing I read for March was Alanna, The First Adventure by Tamora Pierce. I always thought to call her Tamora, but apparently she's Tamora. Apparently the Cardin's audiobook. This is the Alanna series. A read-along is being hosted by Ashley over at the Bookish Realm and Beautifully Bookish Bethany. It's 4 books in the series, and they're doing a book every month. So for March, for February, it was the first book in the series, The First Adventure, and for March, it was the second book in the series, which was In the Hands of the Goddess. I decided to go ahead and check them out I've read them in high school. I read them a very long time ago, and I decided to check out the 2 books on Libby. On my Libby, I haven't listened to them audio because they're really quick audios, only about 5 hours. So I'm able to get through them really quickly. And I just haven't read the series in a really long time. And I was really excited about a chance to reread it. And Ashley has never read them before, so it's really kind of fun to see her experience reading them. So I had to catch up. The reason I read the first one is I had to catch up because I missed February. I didn't have a chance to read it before the read-along. And I really, really wanted to read it for March and check out the live. And it was great. Their discussion was really great, too. So I'm really glad I started rereading it. So this covers Alanna is a young girl and she wants to be a knight. Her brother wants to be a wizard. He's supposed to be going to knight training. She's supposed to be going like basically like essentially like a convent. And they decided to kind of switch places. Alanna goes to become a knight and Tom, her twin brother, goes to become a wizard. Or sorcerer or whatever, he wants to work on his magic. So Alanna pretends to be a boy to become a knight because girls are forbidden from becoming knights. And this is about the first 3 years of her training. It covers a really big span of time. So it covers her from the age of 10 to 13. Tamora Pierce, her writing is so great. Her characters are so great. I love that she was like such a pioneer in YA fantasy, especially for girls, because this is one of the few female YA fantasies like written in the 80s. This genre didn't really exist without her. So Tamora Pierce, she's amazing and also super delightful in person. I just loved re-reading the characters. The nostalgia was real. It was great. I really enjoyed it. 4 stars. And yes, it was just great. And it was just great back into introducing myself to the series. The next one I listened to was also an audio, was Wild Rain by Beverly Jenkins. Beverly Jenkins being a Black author and for historical romance, which I love Beverly Jenkins so much. I've read so many things of hers and continuing to work through her backlist. This particular story was about Spring and Garrett. Spring is a character from the book Tempest, and Spring is, I believe, from Tempest. She's the hero's sister. And so this particular book is about her story, and this is the first attempt of Beverly Jenkins' attempt at a cinnamon hero, which is Garrett. And I just loved Garrett so much. I thought he was a great cinnamon roll hero. Spring is a really tough heroine. She's been through some really challenging situations and challenging things, and Garrett just matched her so well. And she was like, who's like this really genuinely sweet, sweet guy? I can't even handle it. And it was really, really great to see the two of them come together. They had really great chemistry. They accepted each other for who each other was. It was just really, really good. I really, really enjoyed it. And the narration on the audio, which was my first time reading Beverly Jenkins as an audio, was really good. And I rated it 4.5 stars. Next, I read Jaw by Alexandria House. This is also a Black author. This particular book is on Kindle Unlimited. This was about Jay and Trisha. I rated it 3 stars. So this is from the second book from the These Boys series, I believe. And I read Set. I really enjoyed Set, so I was really looking forward to Jaw. Jaw is the youngest brother of the boys, and I totally saw his chemistry that he had with Trisha in the first book in Set, so I was really excited to read their chemistry. And they do come together, but it does involve cheating. Cheating's not really one of my favorite things. I don't really like reading about it. It's not really my thing. Trisha is in a relationship through most of the story and is cheating on her boyfriend while she's continues to be with Jaw. So I didn't really love it. I still like their chemistry. I still like their connection between the two of them, but cheating just isn't really for me. It's not really a big fan of it. But am I still reading the last book in the series, Shu? Absolutely. I still really like the series and I still really like these boys, and they're like really kind of tortured heroes because of they were raised in a very abusive household, so I still really like them. I still really feel like they're great heroes to read about, but this particular book, I still rated it 3 stars, but it wasn't a favorite for me. And next I read an ebook, Hearts on Hold by Cherish Reed. This is also a Black author. This particular book was something I started for Black Author Readathon, didn't finish it in time, so I decided to go ahead and continue reading it. This particular story is about Victoria and John. This is about Victoria as a professor and John is a children's librarian, which I love. I love that trope of them coming together. Male librarian. I just need all the male librarian romances in my life. The steaminess was really, really good between the two of them. The chemistry was really good between the two of them. I really like their connection. I really like them coming together. Victoria goes to John to set up an internship program, and he helps her to do that for her college, and that was why they connected together. I will say the last third of this book really dragged for me. It just kind of felt like it kind of was spinning its wheels for a little bit, and I kind of lost interest for a while, which is probably why I didn't finish it in time. Her mom is very controlling in the book, and she butts heads with her mom often in this particular book. And the conflict with the mom was just resolved too easily. On one hand, I kind of liked it because it went a different direction I thought it would. And on the other hand, I didn't really like it because I just thought it was resolved way too easily. And a controlling mom just doesn't give up that easily in my experience. So probably one of the things I didn't like about it. But also, it has all the fall vibes. So this takes place over September, October, November. And it's just like, there's pumpkin patch, there's a Halloween mansion, a Halloween house that they go to. Like, it's just all the fall vibes, which I just really loved seeing. I don't know why. I mean, it's spring now, so, but I think there's still something really comforting about fall, so I really loved it for that, and I rated it 4 stars. The next one was a book that I listened to. This was The City We Became by N.K. Jemisin. This is also a Black author. This is a fantasy sci-fi, and it is about the 5 boroughs of New York: Manhattan, Staten Island, Bronx, Brooklyn, Queens, and they are fighting against an enemy. The 5 boroughs each get their own what they call avatar, which is basically like a spiritual embodiment of the borough and or the city that they're in. So there's several avatars for different cities. New York has 5 boroughs, so they have 5 avatars, and you follow each of the avatars as they go through and figure out what they're supposed to do to help protect their city against this villain who's called Woman in White. That's kind of all I can say about it because it's kind of bizarre. And I went into it with very little expectations and was pleasantly surprised. It was kind of a wild ride. I didn't really know what was going on, but I kind of still really digged it, and I thought it was really interesting. I thought it was really different. 5 avatars are working together to wake up the New York avatar who has fallen asleep for reasons. Yeah, it was a wild ride, but it was kind of fun and it was a good time and I really enjoyed it. And the audiobook was excellent. The narrator killed it for me and definitely made it for me and made it enjoyable because it is a long audiobook. It's about 16 hours. And I feel like the last few audiobooks that I've had that have been very long, I've struggled through. And this one I read really, really quickly and really enjoyed it. So I rated it 4.5 stars. The next one I read was The House in the Cerulean Sea by T.J. Klune. I finally finished it. I actually have been started it in February and finally finished it in March. And as you can see, my eye makeup actually is what inspired this look. Okay. Anyway, I really enjoyed The House in the Cerulean Sea by T.J. Klune. This is a queer author. This has been called middle grade for adults, and I definitely feel like this book was that. It is about is that Linus Baker, who is a social worker, he goes to a house by the Cerulean Sea where there are six magical children and their caretaker, who is named Arthur, and there's queer romance between the two of them that's a very slow burn and very found family trope. I just thought it was so beautifully written. The writing was really, really gorgeous, and I really enjoyed that. I really liked the relationships between all the characters. It was just so sweet. There was just something so heartfelt about the story that I really, really enjoyed. I definitely think it was a slower read for me and a slower build. And I don't think it's not because I didn't enjoy it, but just because it wasn't something that super grabbed my attention that I needed to like read ferociously. But at the end of the day, I still really, really loved how the story all came together and thought there was something really beautiful in it and really enjoyed it for that reason. And that's where I rated it 5 stars. I think it could have been more of a 4.5, but I don't know. I think especially the writing was so beautiful. And I also, there was so many lines, like I might have to go back through and like tab my favorite lines, because there were so many lines that I just loved that were just so gorgeous. It was just really delightful and really lovely, and I really enjoyed it, and I'm so glad I finally got a chance to read it. The next one I ended up reading was an audiobook that was In the Hands of the Goddess by Tamara Pierce, which is the second book in the Alanna series. It takes place for Alanna between the ages of 14 and 18. And in this case, Alanna is still continuing becoming a knight and her journey through that. I actually really, really like this one. I think this one's probably my favorite installment in the series. I have to get back to you on that because I actually really don't remember the next two books. I remembered this book when I read it or when I listened to it. I was like, oh yeah, these things I do remember. And great representation of young adult having an active sex life. I really love that. That's something that was really revolutionary for its time in the 80s when it came out. Team George for life. Team George. Don't even talk to me about Jonathan. There was a part where I was side-eyeing the age difference between Jonathan and Alanna and George and Alanna, because there is quite an age difference between the two of them. And also they meet her when she's like 11. So it's like, okay, now, like several years later. I mean, I don't know. It's because maybe because the story moves so fast, forward so fast in time, that it's not like the slow progression of them like falling for her more as she gets older rather than like meeting her when she's 11. I don't know. It's kind of weird. But I still love their connection though. And I have nothing wrong with that. Duke Roger is the worst. He's the worst. I mean, and also, honestly, Tom's not so great either. But like I said, might be my favorite in the series. Maybe. I don't feel like I remember the next two books in the series as well as I remember this particular one. So I rated it 4.5 stars. I really, really enjoyed it. The nostalgia is still so, so real. And I can't wait to continue the reread of the series. And next, I listened to an audiobook that was Love from A to Z by S.K. Ali. This is a Muslim author, I believe. Its own voices, because she writes a Muslim character. And this is about Zainab and Adam. It was classified as a YA romance, but I really think this is actually more of a YA coming to age with like a hint of romance. I still really enjoyed it. Adam is struggling with a recent MS diagnosis, and that which his mother has died from. So him struggling with that, as well as they're both Muslim and they have a Muslim romance. So there's something really great and genuine and pure about the two of them coming together that I really liked. Again, though, I think it read more as a YA coming of age with like a hint of romance rather than a YA romance, which is why I rated it 4 stars. Like, I think as a YA romance, I rated it 3, but for the book itself, really mean more coming of age and including a romance, I rated it 4 stars and felt like that fit for me. And just also because Adam is just adorable. I really, really loved his character so much. Zainab came up a little bit more mature and naive, and Adam just seemed like this really wise old soul type of vibe to him that I just loved, that I thought was really great and really fitting. And next, I ended up reading Truth or Beard by Penny Reed as an ebook. This is from the Winston Brothers series by Penny Reed. I feel like I went through a binge of Penny Reed for a while, and I kind of stopped reading her. I don't know. I don't know if it was just her writing style or her plots or her characters. I'm not sure what it was, but I just kind of ended up losing interest in her writing style for a little while. And so I ended up reading this for book club and thought maybe I could go back to it and I would enjoy it again. And I did, but I didn't. It wasn't great. I think maybe I'm still burned down on Penny Reed from here on out, I guess. I don't know. This is about Dwayne and Jessica. Dwayne is part of the Winston Brothers. There's, I want to say, seven of them. And Dwayne ends up being twin brothers with Beau. Jessica has a crush on Beau for most of her life. And Dwayne's always like the brooding, obnoxious, annoying twin brother that bothers her all the time, and but Jessica's a crush on Bo. And then there's a case of mistaken identity where she ends up having a really steamy scene with Dwayne instead, and hijinks ensue from there. I think the biggest problem for me for this particular book was that the plot was really aimless. There was no overarching conflict. It kind of just like jumped from mini conflict to mini conflict, which I guess is okay sometimes, but it was built up to be like a really great childhood rivals, enemies to lovers type of vibe, and it didn't do that. It kind of, that whole set premise kind of fell flat really, really quickly in like the first 20% of the book. And then the rest of the book was just kind of aimless, and I felt like I didn't have an overarching conflict. I felt like there was, miscommunication wasn't an issue, but like really clearly communicating what they wanted was an issue. And Jessica was kind of an annoying heroine. I didn't really like her. I didn't find her funny. I thought she was kind of obnoxious. Yeah, I didn't really love it. There were some funny parts and some great scenes. I kind of liked Wayne. I thought he was, you know, gone for his heroine, which is always fun to read. But I also didn't really understand why he was into Jessica so much, because she just seemed really obnoxious. I rated it 3 stars. I didn't really love it. However, I did like the family dynamic. I thought that was really fun to see. And I was really low-key interested in some of the other Winston brothers, especially Beau's book, because it's a Grump and Sunshine, and the Grump is the girl. So I'm always for that. So I definitely want to check that one out. And I have that one on Kindle. And then Cletus's book. I really, really liked Cletus, and I kind of want to read more about him. And I'm low-key interested in his book. So those ones I might check out. Not sure I'm going to check out the other Winster Brothers in the series, but we'll see how it goes from there. I recently finished one that I haven't added my review to my notes yet, and I'm also in the middle of another one that I'll probably be able to finish tonight, and it is March 31st, so hopefully I'll get it done by the end of the night. And this was all for Tropical Readathons. A lot of these were my Tropical Readathons, but again, I did a lot of mood reading. Some of these were not my TBR. They're just kind of all over the place. I will come back and finish this wrap-up once I finish the rest of the books, my books for March, and then wrap up the wrap-up. And I'm back! Hello! It's now, like, really well into April. It's, like, April 7th today while I'm filming the end of this. And I finished one definitely in March. The other one I read most of in March, but I actually finished a few days ago. But I read most of it in March, so I'm just going to count it for March anyway. And one I definitely started in March, but I really finished in April. Like, it should be my April wrap-up. But I feel like these are the three that I want to talk about to close up my wrap-up. And I'm starting a new journey in April. So for the rest of this wrap-up, I read Clap When You Land by Elizabeth Acevedo. This was a letter as an audiobook. It is about two sisters who don't know about each other. One lives in the United States in New York, and one lives in the Dominican Republic. Their father dies in a tragic plane accident, and the sisters end up finding out about each other and what that entails. It's a really beautiful exploration in grief. It is written more in the style of prose, spoken word, type of poetry, type of vibe to it. It's really, really beautifully done. Because of March and how March has been for me, the grief was a little bit heavier for me. I don't think I appreciated it as much as I probably would have. I don't know if I was in the frame of mind to read this, but it was 5 hours long and I just kind of powered through it. But I think it was kind of a hard thing for me to absorb at the time. I will still say that I think the writing is still gorgeous. And there was a really great aspect of all these different women that were mentioned in the story. Women were really highlighted, and generations of women, women from different classes and from the people who were from America, as well as people in the Dominican Republic. And there was just so many layers of womanhood, and I thought that was really, really beautifully told. There's also like a really badass woman's scene that I just like, I practically cheered. It was my favorite. I still really, really enjoyed it. I thought the audio was really well done. So if you want to enjoy that, definitely would recommend. I rated it 4.5 stars. And next I ended up reading as a buddy read, I read The Deal by Elle Kennedy. That was on ebook. I've seen this one often toted around and a lot of people speak very highly of it. I hadn't read it though. I'd always had been low-key interested in it. I had seen some other people recommend it very strongly though, and so I had gotten it on a Kindle a while ago and just it's been on there for this whole time. I haven't read it. So I finally did. This is about Hannah and Garrett. It is a new adult romance and they're in college. Hannah is a rape survivor, so trigger warnings for mentions of sexual assault and rape. She mentions it often it's because it's a big part of who she is, which I actually really appreciated as a character. I thought that gave her a really interesting character arc and dynamic. They basically pair up because he needs help in his philosophy class. He begs her to tutor him so he can continue to make sure he's on the hockey team. In doing that, they form a connection, and it ends up being really, really sweet. I actually really loved seeing them come together. I felt like Garrett helping her overcome her sexuality issues was really sweet. I thought he did it very thoughtfully and just not something you would see from a college guy, but I just really appreciated that about him. I wasn't really thrilled with the third act breakup scene. I thought it was kind of all, I thought it was weak all around. So the conflict was kind of weak. Just didn't really do it for me, but I still really liked the story overall. I thought it was really sweet. I really enjoyed it. I had a good time. Rated it 4 stars. And the next one is I listened to an audiobook that was The X Talk by Rachel Lynn Solomon. I had been waiting for this book for weeks on Libby. I thought I requested the audio. Apparently I requested the ebook. I had to go back and request the audio. And then I was like 6 weeks behind. I was very devastated and upset by the whole situation. So I was very excited to finally get this. I had been hearing it talked up a lot. And Rachel Lynn Solomon did one of my favorite YA contemporary romances that I read last year, Tonight and Tomorrow. So I was really, really excited to read her first foray into adult romance. I really enjoyed this story. It was about Shay and Dominic, and they're more, it was toted around as enemies to lovers. I really think it's more like rivals to lovers. Like, he's the new hotshot younger guy who comes into the radio station fresh out of grad school, and she's like, been college graduate, started at the radio station, has been at her job for 10 years, and so I think I got more of like a work rivals vibe between the two of them rather than enemies, because she always was like really like low-key attracted to him anyway. I'm going to call it rivals to lovers. And it is, they are radio hosts pretending to be exes. So they had never dated. They were pretending to be exes of each other, that they had actually had this relationship, and they were doing this, hosting this relationship-centered radio show on public radio. And I thought it was still fun. I thought there was, it was very sexy. I thought there was steaminess. I thought they had good banter. I liked that there was a Korean and Jewish rep, which doesn't get brought up a lot and didn't really impact the story a lot, which is okay too, but I still enjoy that they were there in the story. And good buildup between of the relationship. I thought Shay's exploration, her grief, you know, having been 10 years or 10 or 11 years after the death of her own father, was interesting. Yeah, so there was still a lot of layers to it that I really enjoyed. The audio was really well done. I think that one of the things that I really wished I had had is Dominic's perspective in this book. I don't know, I just really, really would have liked to see what his thought perspective was on some of the things that was happening. But otherwise, I thought it was still great, like, going from YA to adult. I thought it crossed over really well. I did see some critiques about Shay sounding immature, which I think because Rachel Lynn Solomon writes YA dominantly, kind of makes sense. But I still didn't really bother me. I still really enjoyed it. I thought Shay was really thoughtful in most aspects. So, and I rated it 4.5 stars. And there you have it. That's my March wrap-up. So my last few months, I've like hit really hard. I had 21 in January, February, I had 18, and this month I only had 12. Which is fine. That's not a problem. I had a little bit of a hard month, so I'm going to take that for what it is and roll with it and just go into April with new vibes. That's the plan. So for my stats, I read 4 ebooks, 1 physical book, and 7 audiobooks, and I had still a pretty good reading month. 1 5-star, 9 4-stars. That's pretty good. 2 3-stars and 0 2-stars. So yeah, so I think that was a pretty successful month for me. Maybe I just rate things everything too high. No, I don't think so. I think I just enjoy reading what I rate. Oh, yeah, I'm gonna go with that. There's still a couple things that I'm in the middle of reading. Physical books are having a hard time focusing on them, so I've been focusing a lot on audio. So I want to also explain, since I'm not doing an April TBR, I'm gonna explain briefly what I'm doing for April. So April, I am low-key participating in 30 mangas in 30 days. That is hosted by Shay Geeks Out and Happy For Now and Library of Tomes, which was Tamika. I will link all the announcement videos of them and their manga. I keep saying the word wrong. I need to get better at this. I will link all their recommendations of the manga to read below. Some of them are Kindle Unlimited, so that's where I'm going to get most of my content. I also bought a couple physicals, so I'm low-key participating in that. And really, for April, I've been going so hard in the readathons the last few months, and March was just such an emotional month for me. I'm taking a step back from the readathons for April. I'm just going to have a mood reading, whatever Bethany wants to do type of April month. I think that's just going to do better for me overall, and I think it's just what I need right now. So I'm going with that. I'm just going to go with the flow. May, we'll see what will happen. I do have some reading vlogs I want to do that are themed that I'm looking forward to. I might start planning those in the next few months instead. So we'll see how it goes out. So I might do secret TBRs for some of the months, some for April as well. I haven't really decided if I'm going to have time for it to do it or not. And that's it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like what you saw, want to see more bookish things from me, please subscribe and hit likes and bells. I would really appreciate it. As well as you can comment down below what your favorite March read was. I would love to know. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again soon. Bye!